angiogram is a diagnostic test that we can perform to look at the coronary arteries around the heart. An angioplasty is the treatment that we can do to widen or unblock any coronary artery that we might find to have a problem.
I was really scared. I was telling people I was nervous, but I wasn't. I was scared. I was frightened it was going to hurt. I was frightened I wasn't going to like the feeling. And I told them I was scared when I got there. I think they could see it on my face. In fact, I was quivering. But they made me feel very comfortable.
Every single patient prior to going into the cardiac cath lab and having either an angiogram or an angioplasty will be seen by the consultant or the registrar, who will go through the procedure fully, and the patient will need to sign a consent form. They have full opportunity to ask any questions at this point that may have been worrying them before they've come here.
When you come into the cardiac cath lab, you'll find that there is quite a lot of equipment. The biggest bit of equipment that you'll see when you first come in is the X-ray machine, and that allows us to use X-rays to obtain the pictures of the coronary arteries.
The cardiac cath labs are our X-ray rooms, our imaging rooms, where we take any patient that's going to have any sort of intervention on their coronary arteries.
We carry out something called a coronary angiogram, which is essentially a picture of the coronary arteries, which supply the muscle of the heart with blood. We work as a team, and I think that's very important. The doctors are simply one member of the team. So we have nursing staff in the cardiac catheter lab, and their role is to make sure that the patient is comfortable. We also have what we call a scrub nurse, who helps the doctor doing the procedure by getting the equipment ready and handing the right equipment at the right times. Then we have the cardiac physiologist, sometimes called a cardiac technician. They are there to monitor the patient continuously before, during, and even after the procedure. The final member of the team is the radiographer, who is the person who is responsible for the X-ray machine and the amount of X-rays that we use.
The procedure itself isn't particularly painful at all. We give local anaesthetic into the groin or into the wrist, depending on which access route we're going to use. Once that tube is in, there should be no pain at all for the patient.
Well, once I got in there and they'd calmed me down, they were talking to me the whole time. I made a little cut in my wrist and they put a wire in. You can't feel it. You only feel the cut. The wire goes into your heart, and then they put a little plastic tube over that wire. You can't feel that either. And they have a look around, then they put dye in and they can have a look, see what your heart's doing. And they can see if there's any blockages or anything that's wrong in there.
When we perform a coronary angiogram, the first stage of the procedure is to anaesthetise a small area of skin. Most commonly nowadays, we use the radial artery, which is essentially where we feel for a pulse. And that then allows us just to feed a very fine wire into the radial artery and then feed a small tube into the artery. That gives us what we call access to the arterial system, and from there we can then pass long but very thin catheters up through the arm and around to the heart. And in fact, you'd be very surprised at how quick that is to do.
You might feel a little tickle or something now and again, like somebody's finger going like that inside by the heart, you know, but otherwise no, you don't feel. No, it's very good. Everybody's nervous because you're going into the unknown with some people. But no, nothing to be nervous about, really.
It is beneficial if the patient can lie as still as possible, but just be nice and relaxed. We can offer sedation, and there will be people in the room, and people will be talking and chatting to the patient the whole time.
The team in the cath lab are very used to dealing with nervous and anxious patients. In fact, I would say that most patients have some anxiety regarding the procedure, which I think is entirely natural, and we're fully expecting patients to be a little anxious. We have an excellent team of medical professionals who are fantastically good at putting patients at ease, even the most nervous of patients. When we've completed the coronary angiogram, we are able to look up at the television screens where the pictures are being displayed in the cardiac catheter lab, and we can then determine whether there are significant narrowings inside the coronary arteries. We then pass a very fine wire down inside the coronary artery that goes through the narrowing and beyond the narrowing. That's something that we call an angioplasty wire. We would then pass a coronary balloon over that wire. So we use the wire as a rail to pass the balloon up inside the coronary artery and then down the coronary artery so we can position the balloon across the narrowing. We then inflate the balloon so that it squashes the artery open again. We will then most often want to insert a coronary stent, which is a metal meshwork which comes essentially flat packed, and in its flat packed form we then pass that down the coronary artery, put it in the correct position, and when we're happy that the stent is in the correct position, we inflate the stent so that it expands, and the stent then expands up and braces the artery in the open position. Both the balloons that we use and the stents that we use show up on the x-rays that we take during the procedure, and that allows us to position the balloons and the stents with a great deal of accuracy so that we can ensure that we're only treating the areas that require treatment. The final part of the procedure is removing the little tube from either the artery in your wrist, if that's where we've inserted the tube, or indeed the artery in the groin. We put a wristband on, that's something that we call a TR band, which puts pressure over the artery in the wrist and prevents the artery in the wrist from bleeding. We would usually keep that wristband on for somewhere in the region of about 2 hours. The risk of serious complications during or after the procedure is relatively low. And I can reassure patients that as doctors, we are constantly looking at the risk of the procedure and comparing that to the potential benefit of doing the procedure. We want to see that the benefit is significant and the risks are lower before we go ahead and recommend that procedure to the patient.
Well, just relax. Relax, and you're in expert hands and you've got nothing to worry about at all.